Okay, another topic we are taking now is rate of change of velocity and the acceleration. So now see, the object is moving on the given path, and we are taking the two type of the motion, uniform motion and the non-uniform motion. So what happen in the uniform motion? When the object cover the equal distance in equal time interval, then we can say that it perform the uniform motion. So in the uniform motion, if you take the speed, then speed is become equal during any time interval. The speed is become equal. Suppose if you are taking the uniform motion, let us take this is the path. In this path, A to B, B to C, C to D. During A to B, here the object covered the distance in the time t. Here also d and time t, d and time t. So during A to B, if you are taking the v1, then it is v. During B to C, v2 is equal to also v. And here during C to D, it is v3 is equal to v. So here, if you take the change of the velocity, the change of velocity, then change of velocity or the speed. The change of velocity is taken as v2 minus v1 during A to C, and it is v minus v is equal to 0. So in the uniform motion, the velocity is constant. This velocity we are taking as a constant velocity. So the change of velocity is constant and equivalent. Change of velocity is become 0 here. It is 0. In day-to-day life, we are using the non-uniform motion. Non-uniform motion. If you draw the uniform motion, the time and distance here, if you draw the graph d versus t, then you will get the straight line. In this straight line graph, here if you draw the slope, then you will get the same slope. The slope of the graph, the slope is given by AB upon BC. It is D upon T. This AB upon BC. So let us take this AB is equal to distance D, and the time interval is given by the T. So this slope gives the V by T. So here also, if you draw any slopes on the straight line, you will get the same slope and the same value. Here also V, here also V. That means your change of the velocity is 0 in the uniform motion. In the day-to-day life, we are taking the non-uniform motion of the object. So in the non-uniform motion, what happens if you draw the graph d versus t? Then the graph is like this, or of any shape, irregular shape graph, where if you draw the slope, then the slope is having different value at different distance and different time interval. So here the average speed or average velocity also you can get, and it is in the non-uniform motion. So the change of the velocity in the non-uniform motion, the change of velocity is not zero. It is not zero. So if you are taking the change of velocity in the given time interval, then we can get the another quantity known as the acceleration. So acceleration is given by change of velocity upon time taken. So the acceleration is given by delta v upon delta t. The unit of the acceleration is meter per second square. So unit of the acceleration is meter per second square or the centimeter per second square, and it is the rate of change of velocity. Another topic we are taking about the acceleration, when there is a uniform motion and there is a non-uniform motion. So when the change of velocity takes place is equal, then we can say that acceleration is uniform accelerated motion. Uniform accelerated motion. What is mean by uniform accelerated motion? When change in velocity are equally change, then this type of the motion is the uniform accelerated motion. Here we can take the delta v upon delta t, delta v1 upon delta t1. Suppose this is the acceleration a1, here acceleration a2 is delta v2 upon delta t2. So here delta v1, delta v2 are same, equal. Delta t1, delta t2 are also same. So in that case, we can say that it is the uniformly accelerated motion, or the uniform accelerated motion. Another we are taking is non-uniform accelerated motion. Here rate of change of velocity are different, and the change of velocity is also different. Change of velocity is different in definite time interval. Delta V1 is not equal to delta V2, is not equal to delta V3 likewise. So this type of the motion is known as the non-uniformly accelerated motion. Now let us take the example based on the acceleration. One example on the acceleration is here. See the one example. Now, a bus decreases its speed from 80 km per hour to 60 km per hour. A bus is going on the path or the road. Its speed is 80 km per hour. Suppose at this point, A point. And its speed is decreased 80 to 60 km per hour. The speed is decreased from 80 km per hour to 60 km per hour during AB, and it decreases in the 5 seconds. The time interval is 5 seconds. So find out the acceleration of the bus. So acceleration of bus is what? So acceleration is delta v upon delta t. So here it is given by v final minus v initial upon t2 minus t1. Here the time is t1, here time is t2. So the time interval delta t is P2 minus P1, that is the 5 second given, Vf minus Vi, final velocity is 60 minus initial is 80 upon 5 second. Now here speed is 80 km per hour, 60 km per hour another speed. Here the time is in hour, and here we have taken the time interval 5 second, it is in second, so we can convert 5 second into the hour. So it is the 5 upon 3600 hour. 1 hour is 60 minute and it is the 3600 second. 1 hour. That's why 1 second is 1 upon 3600 hour. So 5 second is 5 upon 3600 hour. So we can write here 60 minus 80 minus 20 into 3600 upon 5. So it is the minus 20 into 14400 kilometer per hour square. So this is the acceleration. Now we can also convert the acceleration into meter per second square. Okay, so for that we have to convert 80 kilometer per hour and 60 kilometer per hour into meter per second. So 1 kilometer per hour is equal to 1000 meter upon 3600 second. It is 10 by 36 meter per second. So 1 kilometer per hour is 10 by 36 meter per second. So we can convert this 80 kilometer per hour, that is 80 into 10 by 36 meter per second. And 60 km per hour is 60 into 10 by 36. So it is the 600 upon 36. That is the 100 upon 6 meter per second. And here we can take 80 km per hour. That is 200 upon 9 meter per second. Now we can simplify this in same equation. Delta V upon delta T, Vf minus Vi, 60 minus 80, that is the minus 20 kilometer per hour upon time interval T2 minus T1 is 5 second. So it is the minus 20 into kilometer per hour, 10 by 36 meter per second. So we can write it is 10 by 9 meter per second square minus 1.11 meter per second square. So this is the acceleration. So you can write the acceleration's unit in kilometer per hour square or meter per second square. Generally we are writing the unit in terms of the meter, second, like that. So accelerations we can write in terms of the meter per second square. And here the answer of acceleration is minus 10 by 9 meter per second square and it is the minus 1.11 meter per second square. What is the negative sign indicate here? The negative sign indicate that the acceleration is decrease. So it is known as the decrease acceleration, and generally decreased acceleration is known as the retardation, because here the speed or the velocity is decreased as the time is increased. It is retardation, or also it is known as the deceleration. So in this example we explain what is the acceleration, how acceleration is counted. Now in the exercise, another exercise, try to solve the example which is based on the acceleration, velocity, average velocity, speed and average speed. Thank you.